The Philippine Human Rights Commission gets a new chief. Lea Tanodra Armamento replaces Chito Gascon, who died last year. Armamento will serve the remaining term of Gascon until May this year. Before she was appointed to the Human Rights Commission in 2015, Armamento held the posts of Justice Undersecretary and Associate Solicitor. Her appointment as Human Rights Chief comes months before the end of President Rodrigo Duterte's term in June. Duterte has been at odds with the Human Rights Commission over his bloody campaign against illegal drugs.
Our priority is, of course, the extrajudicial killings. And then for me, as a focal commissioner, I am responsible for jail decongestion, anti-torture. So these are my area of responsibility that I want to endorse to the next commission and bank. We are establishing a working relationship with the Department of Justice, and I hope when we leave, in the same manner that the Secretary of Justice Bernard Guevara will be leaving the DOJ, we will have a structure that will continue with the work.
Nine policemen involved in the killing of Calbayog Mayor Ronaldo Aquino have turned themselves to authorities. This after warrants of arrests were issued for them in relation to the case. Aquino died in March last year after being shot 21 times in what witnesses described as an ambush. The mayor's son believes his father's slaying was politically motivated, as Aquino was planning to run as vice mayor in the upcoming elections. The suspects are currently detained in Camp Crame in Quezon City.
Aantayin po natin, sir, yung magiging desisyon po ng korte kung sila po ba ipukumit doon po sa BGMP sa Calbayog o kung saan po ang disposition ng korte. At yun po ang iintay natin. However, pending po sa issuance po ng commitment order, ay mananatili po, sir, sila sa kustodiya ng CIDG dito sa Camp Crame.
Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. retains his lead over his rivals for the presidency in another pre-election survey. The latest SWS poll showed the son of the late Philippine dictator getting 50% of the support of respondents. In a distant second place was Vice President Lenny Robredo with 19%. Tied in third, Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso and Senator Manny Pacquiao with 11% each. Senator Panfilo Lacson garnered 6%, while Labor leader Leody de Guzman got 0.3%. As for the vice presidential post, Marcos's running mate Davao Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio was the top choice with 44%. She is followed by Senate President Vicente Tito Soto III with 33%. Senator Kiko Pangilinan, who is Robredo's tandem, trailed with 10%. Now, the survey was held from January 28 to the 31st, a week before the official campaign period began. It was commissioned by research firm Stratbase ADR Institute.
Cebu's ruling party formally endorses Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio as its vice presidential bet for the May polls. One Cebu issued a statement Wednesday emphasizing its long-standing ties with Duterte Carpio. The group says they've been supporting her since she filed her candidacy for VP back in October. The party, however, did not mention who they are supporting for the presidential race. Cebu currently holds the title of being the most vote-rich province with over 3.2 million registered voters for the 2022 elections, according to ABS-CBN's investigative and research group. Illegal campaign posters taken down by authorities in Metro Manila. Personnel of the Election Commission and the Metro Manila Development Authority removed posters that were either oversized or placed in restricted areas. But the COMELEC came under fire after enforcers were seen dismantling campaign materials in private properties, such as a volunteer center in Quezon City for the tandem of presidential bet Reni Robredo and her running mate, Senator Kiko Pangilinan. COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez explains, campaign materials in private properties are allowed but still have to conform with a size requirement.
The Philippine Elections Commission opened to a review of its strict guidelines on in-person campaigning. Several candidates and their supporters have complained that the campaign rules are overreaching and restrictive. In-person political gatherings such as rallies and motorcades require permits from the COMELEC Campaign Committee.
Our rules regarding the campaign is based on the IFTF guidelines. Now, we are aware of this, the complaints of some candidates. Maybe we will review our rules, because when we drafted our rules, the alert level then was 3.
An advisor to the government's anti-COVID task force, meanwhile, calls for limits to still be imposed on campaign sorties to prevent another spike in infections.
So these are all high-risk activities na sana ikonsideran ng ating mga campaign managers na talagang masunod ng mga followers ng ating mga kandidato yung minimum public health standards at i-conduct yung mga rallies sa open space or sa mga malalaking lugar at hindi naman pupunuin at hindi naman siksikan.
An official of the Philippine Election Commission insists recent turmoil within the poll body will not affect the integrity of the country's May polls. Commissioner Aimee Ferolino describes her recent row with her retired colleague Rowena Guanzon as a minor issue. Ferolino had penned the decision to junk cases seeking to disqualify presidential candidate Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Guanzon had accused Ferolino of delaying the resolution of the cases and preventing her from voting on the petitions before she retired early this month.
That rough patch, that minor issue, will not affect the credibility of the commission as a whole. And whatever the results will be, it's not dependent on a few people. We have the machine, which remains impartial, and we have people on the ground who knows their job and who will continue doing their job without bias.
Ferolino's remark did not sit well with Guanzon. A tersely worded tweet expressed Guanzon's disagreement with how Ferolino downplayed the controversy over Marcos's disqualification cases.
The Commission on Elections has junked the petition seeking to cancel the certificate of candidacy of senatorial aspirant and broadcaster Rafi Tulfo. COMELEC acting spokesperson Socorro Inting says the petition filed by a certain Julieta Pearson last October 25 has been dismissed. In her petition, Pearson claimed Tulfo committed material misrepresentation in his COC when he listed Jocelyn Tulfo as his wife. Pearson in 2019 claimed she is the legal wife of Tulfo, but Inting said there was no misrepresentation in Tulfo's COC. Election lawyer Emil Marañon earlier said Pearson's accusation was not a ground for cancellation since the name of the spouse in the COC is not one of the qualifications to run for public office. Tulfo recently topped a Pulse Asia pre-election survey for senatorial bids.